29th, 1980 something, and I was about to spend the day with the most magical badass I knew, Pops.
Here you go, boys. Toad in the hole for my snuggle face, raisin bran and prune juice for the coolest and most regular daddy I know.
That's a pass on breakfast, Bev. Me and the kid are headed out for a big day on the town.
First, tennis at the club, and if there's time, we hit the art museum.
Honestly, there should be a museum for the two of you. It'll be called the Schmoopy Center for Cuteness, and I will be the curator, and people will line up for blocks just to delight in your deliciousness.
She just had her morning coffee. You go. I'll stay and be a body in the room for her.
And go we did. But not to tennis or a museum, no. We headed to the South Jersey gem known as Atlantic City. Back then, it was a sketchy, degenerate wonderland where they actually let in a baby-faced boy like me. No questions asked. Pop's game of choice was craps. And although no human could understand it, all I knew was that as long as my grandfather had his lucky watch, the man was unstoppable.
Seven out! Seven
out! Is that bad?
Oh, not for us. I dropped the C note on the come at the last second, so now we're up 50.
My God, even when you lose, you win.
Here you go, Al. Seafood buffet on us.
Free all-you-can-eat popcorn shrimp? Seriously, how does this casino stay in business?
As I was living it up with my hero, Barry was beyond desperate to no longer be